warning, a little prisoner down the hallway to the still. I stood up to say goodbye like a whole race. And I heard tell the warning just before he reached my safe. I let my guitar play friends to my request. A little singing back home with a song I used to hear made my own memories come alive. Take me away and turn back the east and send me back home before I die. And I recall that Sunday morning, the choir from across the street evening. Gospel song. And I heard them singers, there's a song my mom sang. You didn't hear it once before you moved along. A little sing. With a song I used to hear, made my own memories come alive. Take me away, turn back years, see me back home before I die. My mama sang, made my old memories come alive. Take me away and turn back the years and sing me back home before I die.
Welcome to Gaspesian Way Live Christmas Show. This is our third one of five. First, want to acknowledge that we are on the unceded territory of the Mi'kmaq people, otherwise known as Shigawake. Very happy to be here, and very happy to be in the community center in Shigawake. Thank you, ladies, for giving me the key, letting us in. And setting up, it's been a while since I've been in here. In fact, the last time I was in here was right before the pandemic started. So it's nice to be back. Thank you guys for coming. I know it's a nasty day, evening out there. It's a wonderful winter wonderland. It's a good day to plant a garden, actually. It's pouring rain. Though these are being broadcast from the week of the day of the 19th to the 23rd, so perhaps when this is being broadcast, it'll be snowy and we'll be making snowmen. So what this is, in 2020 we wanted to do a Christmas show, and of course with the pandemic we were stuck online, we couldn't do them in person. And I mentioned to Kim Harrison, who was the executive director at CAS at the time, that it'd be fun to do a Christmas show celebration. And she said, you should do 12 Christmas shows, do the 12 days of Christmas. And I thought, Well, I had time for one, but okay, 12 sounds like, you know, no life for another 3 weeks. So we did 12 online shows. We did them all through our Facebook channel, and they went well. People loved them. We had great viewership from across the country, even across the continent, even across the world. We had some people tuning in from Australia. And it went really well. So last year we decided, well, we had a new executive director at CASA. His name was Alan. He is Alan. Still Alan. Must have checked. And I said, Alan, I really don't want to do 12 days because that was a little too much. So he said, all right, what do you want to do? I was like, 5. So he's like, okay, we're going to do 5. So we did 5 shows last year. We didn't really know how to do them. So we did like different themes and everything else. And one of the ones that people liked was the Tonight Show format, where we interviewed people, we had music, we did all kinds of fun stuff. So this year, with all the restrictions gone, we're like, hey, why don't we do them in person? Which, I don't remember whose idea that was, but we should really take it up with them, because it's been a lot of work too. But we're doing it in person, so we started last week on Wednesday, we did one in Douglastown, then we did one the next day in Vereshwell, and now we're doing today in Shigawake. Tomorrow we're in New Carlisle at the high school, on the big stage there. And then on Sunday afternoon, we're gonna do one in Gaspesian Angels. And those will be the 5, and they're all being recorded with all this fancy equipment, because Don from the Gaspesian Way is over there doing a fantastic job of keeping us in line and making sure that when I accidentally swear, that we can edit that out later. Thank you. Speaking of swearing and being ridiculous, I'd like to invite my partner in crime onto the stage, the executive director of CASA, and just as ridiculous as I am, Mr. Alan Richards.
That was really long.
That was long.
That was really long.
Well, I got the whole part about the informative part, so people know why we're here. Okay. I can't help but notice that you put on a pound or two since last week.
You know, my shirt?
Your shirt's quite tight.
So in Douglastown, he told me I wasn't wearing appropriate attire.
Right.
And in Bereshwell, I put on a Gaspesian Way sweater. And it's
which is nice.
Still said, so I'm trying to up my game a little bit. So I got my ugly Christmas sweater.
Yeah, but it's a little tight.
Okay, so it's my daughter's ugly Christmas sweater, but it's got tinsel on it and penguin.
So you're wearing your daughter's sweater?
Hey, Dave.
It's 2022, man. You can wear
I think this is the style of it. I think they wear them tight these days. I don't think the baggy sweaters are anything.
Mm-hmm. You think she'll ever wear it again? So
we can edit all this stuff out. Thank you for coming, everybody. We're glad to be in Shigawake. We were down the coast. We're moving our way up the coast, and as I said, everywhere we went, the Gaspesian Way. We created this about 6 years ago to try to promote tourism to English speakers outside of the coast and to connect our communities, connect with each other. And it's really become about that connecting across the coast, and so we're glad to be able to do them in different spots. I'm really happy to be in Shigawake because I'm getting closer to my home, although I'm closer to your home.
Oh yeah, I'm drinking all the stuff from the table tonight and roll up the hill. up the hill. When you're this big, you can roll whatever direction you want.
Don and I will stick around and watch that.
You're pushing. You're rolling like a bale of hay up there.
Shigawake.
Help yourself.
All right.
So what are you pouring there? This first off, these are Oktoberfest wine glasses, which Nathan, you remember getting these. Well, maybe you won't remember getting these. We played at Pit Caribou in Perse as a bit of a fundraiser for Oktoberfest, which is held in Perse in September. September.
Oh, Perse.
September.
I wasn't really listening.
No, you weren't. Thanks for tuning in. Oktoberfest is held in September in Perse.
Right.
That's because everything closes October 1st.
So everywhere we've gone, we were in Gaspé, we drank Cat Gaspé beer. Mm-hmm. We were in Bereshwell, we drank Caribou, of course, and some Oval.
Yes.
We had the Oval, it was very good. Now we're in Shigawake, so we're in the Mercy of Bonaventure.
We should be drinking milk.
Only we knew a farmer that could give us some milk.
And like, I got a bottle of vodka at home too. I could have got the vodka.
Yeah, nothing could go wrong with this. So we have Julia Rose wine from Bordage in Saint Simeon. Really excellent wine, which I haven't tasted yet. And of course, we have the Naufrageur, we have the Colburn, which is kind of apropos because we're just up the coast from where the Colburn actually went down.
So right.
A red called the Colburn.
Do people even know what the Colburn is?
It was a shipwreck. I'm sure Doug Hunt knows what it is.
I'm sure Doug Hunt knows.
If we called him on the phone, we could probably do the rest of the show just on the Colburn.
Well, Naufrageur is French for
the shipwrecked ship.
The wrecked ship?
The person who was shipwrecked, right? The Naufrageur.
Okay.
Isn't it?
I don't know. You asked the right guy. You have no
idea. They don't have help me.
Cheers, Roman.
He who was shipwrecked, I believe, or she who was shipwrecked.
It's love.
That's the dude.
Okay. So you got the Colburn.
Yes.
So Colburn went down in...
Off Mackerel Point in Gaston.
Right.
Point Mackerel in Gaston.
Mackerel Point. Mm-hmm. And the Doris?
The Doris, I don't
is
know.
Is it Dory? Just looks like a little boat.
Doris. Doris is fishing.
Is his name Doris?
Yeah, but he's fishing halibut. So I don't think he went down, I think he just fished. Just sure. Drink the beer, Dave.
All right, so you got one more thing to say.
Oh yes! I don't remember that. Oh yes!
Can we text him and find out what's
going on? No, I got it.
Okay.
The other part of this is we're recording them, and traditionally the last 2 years, they have lived on Facebook.
Yes.
Facebook Lives, which is what it is. So on Facebook is fine, but it lives online and it's not ours. And what we've done with our partners at Vision in Gaspé and Cami in the Magdalene Islands is we created an online platform called Bonfire Media.
With a Y.
Bonfire with a Y, because we're hip and cool.
Yeah.
It's 2022. And so all of our media is going to live on there, not for this live show, but for the next one. We're going to be launching it in January. So keep an eye out on our Facebook pages, Kaz's page, Tammy's page, Vision's page, and now the Bonfire Media Facebook page. Look it up and like it, and you'll get all our notifications and everything that we are doing here. It's going to live on there. We're going to have captions for information for all kinds of different things, the programming at Kaz's. We're going to have news. We're going to have stories. Tom Eaton's telling a whole bunch of stories.
Yep.
Half of them are true. And we're going to have music. We're going to have all kinds of stuff. It's a cultural space for the English-speaking community, the Gaspé and the Magdalene Islands, and everybody's welcome.
And what's really cool is, there's something you probably don't know about this guy, is he's actually, were you born? You weren't born here, were you?
I was born in Gaspé, man.
Oh, were you?
Gaspé, huh? Not like you, I'm not from Niagara Falls.
I'm from Niagara Falls. Go Leafs, go. Weren't you born over... No, weren't you from something?
I lived in the Magdalene Islands for a while.
You lived in the Magdalene Islands.
So I'm truly a regional person. I was born in Gaspé, lived in the Maggies, grew up in New Cardall, and now I'm a Pastor Jack.
That's good. <hard. laughs>
Covered all
my things. Anyway. But it's cool because of Bonfire, is you're able to connect with that community, which we're kind of a part of, but they're so far away because there's like a ferry ride and or a never on time plane ride to get to the Magdalene Islands. So it's going to be cool because they're going to be posting stuff online as well, so you're going to be able to see what our friends and family, their family, are doing over the Magdalene Islands. So,
yeah.
Cool. Anything else? I saw some people come in that I want to talk to.
Uh-oh.
I saw that they came in with a bag. Is that Fourchette over there?
Oh.
Huh? Yeah? Do you want to come up and just... Yeah?
I think this is my cue to leave.
Well, you can stay if you want, because she's bringing Fourchette. Come sit. Come sit at the table. Come sit at our supper, Christmas supper table. Have a cracker.
Oh, what's that?
Oh, I don't know. Try and see. Whoa!
Oh.
We can edit that out. It's all good.
I didn't finish the story.
I know.
I didn't finish the
story. I can do one too.
Wow.
Oh, that one looked right here. Okay, so what do you got?
I don't know. It looks like a cracker.
Yeah. So pathetic.
This didn't get green.
Need orange.
Well, it's better green.
Really?
Yeah.
It's good.
Well, there's nothing.
They used to come with toys. Oh, they come with stickers.
Oh, they do.
Oh, look it. Stickers.
I've got some stickers for Sydney right there.
And? Oh, and my fortune apparently.
What do you mean? You got a fortune? I got nothing.
I think it's a dad joke.
Oh, it's a dad joke. Here you go. You ready for this?
Alright.
What did one magnet say to the other? I find you very attractive. Where's your dad joke?
I didn't get one, or it flew away somewhere.
Okay.
I didn't get a dad joke.
So what did you bring in this lovely tinfoil wrap?
I brought you some stuffed chicken fetus.
Don.
You called it.
Ooh.
Chicken fetus.
Check this out. This is from the Fourchette, which is closed.
It's closed, yes. They're closed for the season, thank God.
So these are cold? No.
No, they're still warm.
Turn down a little bit.
Right on the edge.
Right on the edge. So, tell me something.
Okay.
First off, tell me who you are. Who are you?
My name's Colleen.
You are Colleen?
Yes.
You're from the Fourchette?
Yeah, I own the Fourchette.
You own the Fourchette?
Yeah.
Do you just boss people around or do you cook?
No, I'm actually in the front. I serve people. Yeah.
So you serve and boss?
No, I let my sister do all the boss.
Oh, okay. So, listen, the Fourchette, when did you open?
Probably our 8th or 9th year now.
Really?
Yeah. We started a smaller camper at the log cabin.
Right.
We moved to a bigger camper here, and then from there we went into this one.
8 or 9 years, and you've renovated the old gas
yes.
station?
Yes. Well, we're almost, we're 80% renovated. There's a lot of work to be done in that old gas station, so, but it's looking pretty good.
Nice. So, this is the thing. When you ask people around the coast, I'd say if you asked them 10 years ago what the best canteen was, often they would say Bergeron's in, I think it's Bonaventure, right? And then there's one down that way. Anybody, you guys know it?
I think it's in Gaspé. It's Jen's, could it be? Jen's?
No, but I'm thinking there's one in Gascon or something everybody talks about. The what? Bodé's! That's it. That's what I was looking for. And of course, I'm a big fan of Canteen Kenny's pizza. I've always got the pizza from there because it's just, you know, it's good and yummy. But then all of a sudden, 8 or 9 years ago, there's a little thing over here at the log cabin. And then here, and then you guys had like a little mobile unit a little bit.
For a while we had a festival truck that would do some of the festivals, but it kept growing at the canteen so much that we didn't have time for that.
Understaffed.
Not even so much understaffed, there's only so much you can prepare for, and the amount of tourists that pass through the canteen in the summer, it's hard to prepare for the canteen and then prepare for a festival truck with like hundreds of thousands of people at a festival.
That's it.
So it's just hard to keep up, so we let go of the festival truck.
But I do work from one end of the coast to the other. Everybody now knows La Fourchette.
That's awesome.
I tried,
and now hopefully a lot of people will come and pick me up.
But, and I tried to help make, you know, the fair music festival a thing that Shigawake's known for, and you've kind of screwed me over. Because now they say
the fairs are pretty good, because, you know, I have people coming into the canteen asking where the fair is. So.
Well, I'll have people going to the fair and say, where's the food shop? It's kind of annoying. But anyway, no, it's good because it's first off, I can roll to your canteen.
You can roll back up.
I definitely have to roll back up because by the time you're done eating. So what are you known for? I can tell you what I know you're known for.
We're known for our fish and chips.
Yes, of course.
But we have a pretty eclectic menu. You know, we've got great stuff on our menu. We're always adding new things every year. We've got a dirty potato this coming up next year.
I hate potatoes.
Oh, but
I especially hate dirty ones.
Got dirty potato. We've got submarines that are going on the menu next year. So.
And you got pizza.
We got pizza all the time.
Because I'm a pizza guy.
Yes, but you love Cameron's pizza, so you got to eat Cameron.
I don't mind eating it twice a day. So this is like, oh, I never even thought you guys should have had like a rock, paper, scissors war between canteens or something. Just scrap it out because like you could have had a wrestling.
A pizza off.
Why was I not thinking this?
We're both closed, so I don't think either of us want to do
it. Yeah, I think so.
Damn, but that was, maybe we'll do a summer. I'm liking where the Gaspesian Way can go with this. We can totally do a pizza tasting. Then we can do a beer tasting with the pizza tasting. I love this job.
Doesn't get better than that.
For sure, anything, for sure. Anything you want to share? Anything else you want to share with the Fourchette that we should all know? When do you open back up, first of all? Is it always like when
probably the end of April.
When the snow's gone?
Yeah. Well, not so much the snow's gone. I don't have
it's
to
gone.
Be gone.
It's gone.
Exactly. It doesn't have to be gone, but I'm thinking important. The end of April, beginning of May, like usual.
Yeah.
Maybe towards the end of April.
Does the
weather's good.
The winter, staying over the winter, just not worth it? Or is it the heat?
No, it's not. It's for one heating. Like, again, that was an old garage, eh? You know, we've got it pretty well insulated, but it's going to get cold anyway. And it's a big building. We have two huge hood fans because we have two separate kitchens in there. So that sucks up a lot of the heat, too.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, and the employees, they're tired. Like, you know, the canteens, they get roughed up over the summer. They really do. We have a lot of tourists that come to Gaspé, so... And I think we all hit the canteen, so...
Well, that's the thing. In the summer, everybody goes... You go anywhere on the coast, it's the poutine, quarter chicken dinner. You guys have a wide variety of a menu, which is great.
Yeah, we've got Mexican, we've got Greek.
Do you even have quarter chicken dinner?
No.
Oh, so there you go. So you're totally off the charts when it comes to that?
Yeah.
And
but a little secret.
What?
There's probably going to be a really awesome fried chicken coming next year.
Oh, yeah.
Not the quarter chickens, but a really nice fried chicken.
Now you're going after Dixie Lee.
No, I'm going after Dixie Lee. That's it.
That's good luck. Good luck. That's a beast, Dixie Lee.
It is. And it's a chicken coast. It really is. You know, the coast loves chicken.
That's right.
You know, we did quarter barbecues, but yeah,
that's nice.
That's one of our biggest sellers is the pita.
So, why is it? Well, I understand why, but it's sad that us Gaspésians have to go hungry all winter long.
I know, and I even have people messaging me from January to February saying, "I know you have ingredients, just make it for me at home." So yeah, people definitely start getting aggressive towards January, February. Like, you know, they want their loaded Mexican, or they want their chicken pita.
So with that being said, is there anything else you want to add?
I'm good. Just make sure you come and visit us during summer when we're open. We're open usually from May, well, the end of April to December, to November, actually.
Yeah, this was a special treatment.
Yeah, this was a special treatment.
You gotta know people.
I kept some aside for you. You know, I knew you were wanting, so I kept them aside.
It's awesome.
Well, thank you.
Thank you for coming. Thank
you
for it. And
I look forward to that pizza.
Yes, so do I.
I know,
so
right?
Do I.
She doesn't want me to give her more work, so she's trying to opt out of it. But it's going to happen.
Well, you want to take on Dixie Lee, we'll get Dixie Lee in here. We'll go with the Porchette versus Dixie Lee, chicken and pizza.
I have no problem.
Nathan, are you up for a little taste test?
I mean,
Nathan loves the pizza. I'm not worried.
I'm so excited. I'm so excited. I'll say that. Thank you very much.
I've got the tiger by the tail, make me sick. Won't be much when you get through to me. While I'm losing weight and dreaming, not the bait. Looks like I've got a tiger by the tail. Well, not the day I'll meet you, a big cancel man. Just a guy to feed my dreams and whims. Oh, we found the same, and it looks like I've got a tiger by the tail. I've got a tiger by the tail. Stay the same.
like to be part of our Port Daniel and Hopetown Wellness Centers, please call CASA at 418-752-5995. We would love for you to join us. That number again, 418-752-5995. Bye.
When it comes to Shigawake, which I moved to back in 2006, because I originally came to Richmond and I moved here in 2006, it's been known for a lot of things. There's a fishing community, there's fishing, there's a lot of farming, as I've come to find out and appreciate.
Tractors,
cows, lots of stuff. There's the agricultural fair, but there's something else about this community that it's known for. And sadly, when you go to this place, it's just outside of Shigawake. It's not Shigawake anymore. It's like Port Daniel West. It's Marcel.
Okay, I had no idea. Glad you said Marcel.
Anyway, so and what this place is known for is their Christmas thing. If you go back, Route Benwell, I think it's called Route Benwell, yeah. Benmore Road, the second, essentially, and you head
the
east.
The second what, then?
The second.
The second?
The second range.
Oh, the range.
Don't ask
that
me.
That makes more sense.
I'm from Ontario. We have lines and concessions, and it's always, but here it's like
ranges.
Ranges. And there's no first range. Nobody lives on the first range. The first range is called 132.
What first range?
Yeah, I guess so. It used to be called Route 6. Which, I don't know why you didn't call your band Route 6.
Route 6.
I know, it should be Route 6.
Yeah.
Just drop a 6.
It's easier.
Or drop 60. You know,
rebranding.
Anyway, so second range. So if you go down and go back Sullivan's Lane, and you hang a right, and you're going down Route Benwell, otherwise known as the right, that way. You're going east. And you're going down the second range. At Christmas time, or at least in the month of December, it's lit up. Lit up.
I've been.
You've been? Mm-hmm. Who hasn't been?
Who hasn't?
In fact,
it was voted number one.
It was voted number one. We did the Family Feud in Douglastown, and I surveyed 100 Gaspesians, and 60 Gaspesians of the 100 said the best lights on the coast are in Marcel. Right?
Wow. So, and none of them.
So, I went back there the other day to visit Nikki Donhott, who is one of the houses, and we're actually going to talk with her up here on stage later. There's no wine left here, by the way. So I went back and I interviewed, so you guys can watch the screen. This will be like more part of the episode later, but this is our little interview the other night.
Hi, we are here at Nikki Don's house in Marcel, back on the second range in West. And we're going to be talking to you on stage a little bit later anyway, but I wanted to show everybody what we got going on back here. As you can see, it's very well illuminated. How many bulbs and stuff you got going on?
I have no idea.
No idea.
No. I haven't kept track. No.
Do you have to keep track of your hydro bill? What's your hydro bill like?
Not much different.
Really?
Not yet. There's a lot of people have asked me the same, but it's about $80, maybe $100 more.
Oh, wow. Just to let you know, we did a family feud, surveyed Gaspesians, 100 Gaspesians, on where the best place to go check out Christmas lights is in Gaspésie.
Okay.
And 60 of the 100 Gaspesians said this street right here.
Yeah.
So that's pretty impressive. From all around the coast, people in Gaspésie say, yep, we got to go to Marcel. So that's pretty cool. So last year you had Dominic Brion play a song and you recorded it and it was all put through your lights and it was all synced up, right?
Yes.
And this year, do you have any local music?
No, I don't.
You don't?
No. But you know something, buddy. You know some people, musicians.
Yeah. Yes. Hey, Mary Lou! Mary Lou!
Hi.
Oh. You have a Christmas song now, right?
Yes.
Perfect. Basically on beat, trees were singing with her, the guys on the roof were singing with her.
Yeah, back
to the fan.
It was fantastic. And if you like that song, it is out on Spotify and iTunes and all that stuff. Go check it out. She was good enough to do it for us. So thank you, Mary Lou. When we come back, we are going to play a game, actually, when we come back. We're going to play a game, and then after we play the game, we're going to interview the light beam. We're going to play a game. All right, so in the meantime, let's listen to Mom and Dad. I'm not sure. It's just reeks up here. It's our breath. So we're going to play a little game?
We're going to play a game?
Or not? No.
Is it pin the tail on me?
Pin the tail on... I didn't say pin the tail on me. Donkey. So, for this game... I'll speak loud because I'm waiting for the microphone. For this game, I need Alan to stand in front of the table here. Yeah, right. See, the best thing about being the host of the show is that my co-host doesn't always know what the hell I'm doing.
Never know what he's doing.
So I can just do whatever I want.
Oh, he's leaving.
Hi, Dave.
So, this game, I have five bags, and in these bags are Gaspesian items. And Alan, you're going to stick your hand in this bag, feel it, and tell us what the item is, without looking.
Okay.
So look towards your mom and dad. Look towards mom and dad, okay? Yeah. Put your hand in the bag. Yeah. All right, and this Gaspesian item number one is... Oh!
That is exactly what this is.
What is it?
It's a paddle.
It's a paddle? What would a paddle be from?
A paddle from Tipsy Canoe?
Tipsy Canoe. Take a look at it. You are indeed right.
A Gaspesian Way paddle.
A Gaspesian Way paddle.
A shameless plug.
Shameless plug.
Is that an elf on a shelf paddle?
It's a small paddle.
You can tell them a bit about Tipsy Canoe. Tipsy Canoe.
Tipsy Canoe is Caitlin Carter in Grand Gaspypedia. She did this for us. We commissioned this one. They're all one of a kind. They're all unique. But she's got lots of different paddles, lots of different books. We have keychains at the Gaspesian Way that were made for us.
Right. Thank you. All right. Perfect. Good job. Nothing. No. So next one. You put your hand in. And it's just a case of, what is this item? Yeah. Just what is it?
It's a mouse trap.
What is it?
I know what that is.
What is it?
It's a flyer.
It's a flyer. You're right.
Is this supposed to be difficult?
Do you heard it?
It's a left hand reel.
I was thinking. Good job. Flyer.
That's a small little water.
Frank and I know different flyers.
Alright, here we go. Next one. That's my flyer. Every time I go fishing, Alan lets me use his own stuff, so I never need to use mine. So it's nice to pull it out. Actually, alright.
Okay, it's a bottle.
It's a bottle. A Gaspesian bottle. What would it be?
Oh, it's gonna be some gin.
Yeah.
From?
Maliko.
Let's see. Yeah.
Also from San Simeon?
No. Caitlin.
Caitlin? Yep. That's only half full,
eh? I know why he's talking like this.
It might be empty by the time we're done here today.
Curse speech. The rest of you? Very good gin.
Alright, ready for this next one?
This is easy.
This is easy game? Easy game? Alright, here we go!
It's wet. Do you remember?
No.
Oh, it's a french fry from Dixie Lee.
Just a french fry?
Good from 3 years ago. It's a dinner from Dixie Lee.
Well, it's a Dixie Lee dinner! Cass had bought that a couple hours ago, so it's good.
I've got my hands in it.
Yeah, it's definitely yours. Yeah. Alright, last one! There it is.
Give us a lot of thought, man.
Everything smells like fish up here. But I just want to point out, because I was being accused of stuff that I don't want to be accused of, that I didn't have the receipt for these two fish that I purchased. They were best before October 29th, 2021. So they're ripe. But they had been in the freezer. Those two fish I purchased at Produit Marin Saint-Gaudois for $1.84. That was the 2 years ago. No, year and a bit ago. And Frank, you tell me I could double my money if I sell them now?
Yeah, I was thinking about that. You could probably even do better than that.
Oh, yeah?
If you go and get them when the
So welcome back to this fiasco. I'd like to invite up the creator of that winter wonderland you saw on the screen, Miss Nikki Dawn. Can I interest you in a fish taco?
No.
Can I interest you in a fish?
Dollars.
So it does smell fishy, right? Listen. I don't know, when did this whole thing start back then?
I've been dealing with blow mold for about 6 years.
Okay.
What started out as a competition has now turned into no longer a competition, but
a competition with who?
Just competition. Well, for Daniel in general. No. But no, now it's more of I do for the community. More of the people, more of the kids. Yeah.
Well, that's it, because I mean, your house is well decorated, but it seems to have inspired a lot of other houses because you drive back there and it's.
But I think we. Not necessarily. It's always been kind of.
Back there?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's always been a few houses, probably a little bit more now than before. But yeah, it's.
But there's so many Santas. There's so many snowmen.
I
don't
know, I'm having a problem with that.
Right? There should be one Santa, not 45. So, okay, so you have a lot of Santas, a lot of Frosties, yeah. In fact, what you don't see in the beginning of that video, the very beginning of that video when I called Mary Lou, she turned and almost decapitated Santa with a guitar. You hear it, ka-dunk, ka-dunk, and that's why she started chuckling, because poor Santa took a header. So there's Santa's in there. What's going on with the trees and the other stuff?
Okay, well, that started about 3 years ago, and I always wanted to get into lights that was synced with the music.
Yes.
Which, like I said, it started 3 years ago, but now I took a tree that had 1,500 lights onto it, and I am now at 10,000 of them.
10,000 lights on that tree that's...
Well, not on specifically that tree, my house, snowflakes, singing, okay. Decorations.
It's a lot of lights.
In that area, that's not counting me. None of the rest of the LEDs.
Okay.
Yeah.
And the hydro bill, you said, if you didn't hear it in the video.
Those lights there that are playing with the music are actually half of what a normal Dell light would take.
Okay.
So, oh, wow. Yeah.
So it's not too bad.
No.
Has this inspired you to do more than just Christmas? Because I just want to say I heard something about Halloween lights this year.
I did start Halloween. It wasn't this year. It's been a few years as well. That's been my third or fourth year of Halloween. However, Christmas is taking over. Okay. It's getting longer than now to put up. It's much more than a month now. Like, yeah, then. I am a month and a week in, and I still have 1, 2, 3, 4 other things to put out. So, yeah.
I put a sled on my front lawn that I've not plugged in yet. And you're...
So I think Halloween's out the window.
Because you're setting up Christmas in August, so you don't have time for Halloween.
That's what it'll be in about another 2 years.
Alright, So here we are. Okay, so these lights go on, you turn them on. Now listen, when I said I was coming with Mary Lou, because I don't know if you noticed, it was kind of staged, but she was actually there. But I was coming with Mary Lou, and you like had a mini freak attack because you had to have this power supply and you had to have these lights, and you weren't showing no public nothing until it was just so.
Yeah.
So, and like, you even know the delivery guy's name and phone number to call and say, bring my crap, or I'm going to beat you up or something like that.
It'll get out. Don't look at that far.
You were taking it a whole other level, I know.
Yeah, the day before that, I had tried a power supply, so I was in complete panic mode because, like, the right side of the house was not completely lit up in the lawn. So, like, I kind of lost the whole right side of the house.
And there's an equilibrium, like, if it's not.
It dances all together.
It dances all together.
Right? Yeah, I wanted to look right.
Right. So those lights go on. They take you through Christmas. Now, just, I gotta say, when I parked, when Mary Lou, myself, and my daughter Abby got out to do the filming and everything else, the four-ways had to be on because there was other cars driving by super slow, just checking out everything on the second range. How many cars pass by daily?
The weekdays are pretty calm. The kids are still slow, which is normal. The weekends, I would, yeah,
it's crazy.
I haven't counted. Like, I've got videos where it's been blocked on both sides of the world where people, like, you know, like, Snapchat me, can you move these people?
We've talked about, actually, my wonderful wife mentioned that the Gaspesian Way should maybe do a December 1st lights of Root Benwell launch and have, like, you guys playing back there on stage, everybody's lighting up their lawn, just make a whole Christmas festival back on a second next year.
I think that's great. Hey? Have a light raising party.
There you go. Frank's going to be back
there.
It
cuts down from a month to 2 weeks.
Frank's going to be back there selling fish. You know, he's a fishmonger in the back. But this makes me wonder, actually. It was kind of, thanks for the segue, Frank, because I was thinking, if all these cars are driving slow by your house, are you out there selling swag? Like, are you out there selling the Root Benmo? You should be selling the t-shirts. Mm-hmm. If all these cars are driving by super slow, 25, $3 t-shirts, somebody buy? Coffee, even, if it's cold?
I do serve hot chocolate.
You serve? Serve.
Oh, yes.
Do you sell?
No, serve freedom.
This sounds like a wonderful business. We have some wonderful people. We have some wonderful people at XMECO Credit or the MRC that you should talk to about developing a business model. Because I think you got all kinds of customer drumwares that you could. This could be the Anna Green Gables of Gaspin. I'm just saying. Like, this could be it. Alright, so my final question is, when does the boo-hoo happen? When do you pull the plug on that, which is
to finish
the light show.
Completely. Yeah. The first weekend in January.
First weekend in January?
Yeah.
That's it? Really?
Hey, I get off work until August. I fall into Halloween. Okay?
All right.
From Halloween to Christmas. January's up.
So you're saying it's a competition back then?
What started it as
a competition?
For me, I'm speaking for myself, it's no longer.
You're not a competitive type of person?
No. No.
That's good to know. Because when we come back from a little break, we're taking you on in a decorating competition, and we're going to show you who's the boss.
Yeah.
Right here in this hall, right after break.
Okay.
You're going down. Woo.
I will have a blue Christmas. Without you, I'll be so blue, just thinking about you. Decorations of red on a green Christmas tree want me to send it if you want me with me. Oh, windows blue.
Sleigh. try this with me.
Jingle bells, jingle bells all the way.
Yeah.
Your lights are still in boxes. What's gonna happen? You guys are gonna play a song?
And that's a short song.
What?
A short song.
I want to stay away to heaven. When he starts, we start. Wait, wait, go.
She's not roasting. I don't know the fly.
Why is that not frozen? Really?
It's a heat.
Jack Frost nipping.
I get to like you. Do the wall.
Yuletide carols. Been sung by choir and false dressed up. death is known. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe. Well, to make the season bright, tinted tops with your eyes on a glow, when your heart is hard to sleep tonight. They're only Santa's on his way. He's told the lots of toys and goodies on a sleigh. And every modern child is gonna spy when we see if reindeer, do you really know how to fly? And so it's from 1 to 92. All found has been said many times, many ways. Merry Christmas to you. Thank you.
greeting from the Gilker residence, and I would like to thank Skaza and Madeline and all our team to take care of our residents. Thank you very much and happy holidays.
So the house, the family house, was the first house in Clemville. Yeah, and that's a house where all the people around in Clemville go to make the party.
So you're the party guy.
Yeah.
So you just renovated your house. We can all go to your house and party at your house now.
No, you speak too quickly for me.
Your house.
Yeah.
You renovated.
Yeah, sure.
It's new.
Yeah.
We have a basement.
Yeah, you have a basement?
Nah.
We have a basement. Nah. Good job.
Thank you.
And a nice one. You're going to like it.
Yeah, so we're all going to go to your house and party.
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
So,
thank you guys for coming. Okay, and so tell me, you're playing music, you got older, you're still playing music, you got older and older and older, and then...
He met me.
And everything got better.
Yeah, sure. All the things are better.
So what happened here? How did this musical marriage happen?
Tonight?
No, but in general.
In general, well, I don't know.
Well, thank you guys for coming.
Thank you.
It's fantastic. And these guys are fun to play Irish tunes with too, because Catherine started playing the fiddle a year and a half ago. And like, she's amazing. Like, she's she joins us on stage for Irish Narrows when we do Irish stuff.
Oh, thank
and
you.
It just makes everything perfect. I mean, Dominic's good too. Nathan's okay. But she just makes, she just fills it. So thank you, you guys are awesome.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
All right, so the last part of our night, I want to call up Mr. Nathan Hayes to have a little, very, very brief chat with him. Just a brief chat. Just come stand here. Come stand here. All right, so I won't keep you long. Quick question. Who's the best drummer that you play music with?
Danny Robertson's.
Anyway. Jim and this guy won't seem pretty good. I'll just use the other guy because I have to. So tell me about why you got into music. Did you live in a 176-year-old house too?
No, 100-year-old house, no. But, yeah, my parents play music. My grandmother always played organ at the church.
Yep.
And so we grew up around music my whole life. And because my sister as well got into music at the same time, so we were kind of like back and forth with each other at the same time. Kind of pushing each other, trying to be better than the other one.
Who's better?
She's better. Quite a bit.
We booked the wrong person.
She's actually.
That's cool. So, are you recording? Have you recorded?
No, I've done a little bit of recording, but nothing I've really wanted to keep. So.
Oh, no?
But, soon enough, we're pretty busy.
Yeah.
So, hard to find the time.
So nothing that you want to keep. So what you're telling us is that the next songs you're going to play aren't that good? Is that what you're
oh, no, they're good. They're just the recordings I didn't bring.
Maybe
they're not that good. I don't know. Well, you'll be the judge of that, I guess.
We have a studio in the basement of Casa now that's all ready to rock.
Yeah.
There's also a guy who's got a party house that records as well. So, I mean, there's no excuse anymore for anybody to not record. If they think they got a chance to record something, there's lots of places to record it. So.
And it's free for you.
Yeah, it's free for you. Free
oh,
for
well, it's close to the nuclear law, so I'm stopping there
for you.
Oh, it is? Okay, yeah.
All right. All right, so let's hear these okay songs that you say. I want a big round of applause for Nathan Hayes.
A couple originals. Had some writer's block lately, but so these are a little bit old, but do them anyway. Thank you. feeling. A slow one. Finger picking, a little bit practice.
Oh, this way I've been living in a corner of shame in my mind. Light.